Child, this is some news that done came out the other day. So Chris Brown allegedly is being sued by a woman who claims that he R'd her on a yacht parked at Diddy's Star Island home. Now, this is according to a new $20 million lawsuit. Singer is being sued by Jane Doe, who says she was a professional choreographer, dancer, model, and musical artist. And she claims that Chris went from being friendly to her.
But sexually assaulting her.
Sexually assaulting her. Mm-hmm. You know, YouTube, you know, I don't know about certain words you can't say. And according to the suit obtained by TMZ, the woman claims that Chris grabbed the phone of a friend that FaceTimed her, that urged her to come over to Diddy's house. And, you know, at his Miami Star Island. And things went from there. Now, I don't know. I mean, I think this is starting to be like a yearly thing. You know, a lot of his fans that came out and was like, oh, well, they do this every year. This is, they're obviously lying, because the last case that happened, like, he actually won. So what are y'all talking about? I just want to put this into perspective. Like, when this stuff was happening to R. Kelly at first, like, he was winning cases too. So I wouldn't be so like, oh yeah, they lying. I don't know, child.
At this point, between Chris Brown and Trey Songz and R. Kelly, I'm like, what does the R stand for in R&B anymore? Like, my goodness gracious. And you know, it's unfortunate. I may not be the biggest Chris Brown fan, but I do think that it is unfortunate that, you know, God, it must be exhausting to really be trying to focus on, you know, your music and your career, and your personal life always gets in the way, right? We're not talking about his new single. We're not talking about him trying to do a virtual tour, or do a tour or residency or anything like that. You're making headlines for assaulting a person that's in your core fan group. And I think that hits you the hardest, because I thought about the same thing when it was the R. Kelly thing. Like, as a woman, how do you support someone who's accused of these things, right? These monstrous things towards women. How do you appreciate their music the same way? And I know people who love Chris Brown down, you know, who make babies to his music. But it's like, okay, well, if this is the type of person he is, or these are the things that he's doing to people in this core demographic, how do you appreciate their music the same? It's the same way I feel about artists like Lil Boosie. Now, I'm from Louisiana. You know, we're Louisianimals and all that kind of stuff, and supporting him. But when he started going on this homophobic and transphobic rant, it's like, I can't appreciate your music the same.
Yeah.
Knowing that personally, this is how you openly speak towards my community, regardless of, oh, I have gay people working on my staff and I'm cool with them, blah, blah, blah. It's not for everybody. It's just this one person. I'm like, well, you're targeting people that you don't even know personally, and you're making blanket statements that will affect the entire community, regardless if that person next to you turns a blind eye because they know you and they're on your payroll, right? So with this whole Chris Brown situation, I'm like, listen, we'll hear what the lady has to say. When it comes to these allegations, I feel like you're innocent until proven guilty. That's how the system is designed. So yes, people can come out, you know, they always like, I believe her. It's like, you don't know this woman from a can of paint. You don't know what people's motives are. Mm-hmm. If this is the allegation, file a police report, take it to court, let there be, you know, a discovery, bring your evidence, and then try your case in court. And then we'll see what the judge and the jury decides.
Yeah.
And that will henceforth, you know, lead us to the truth as to what the reality is, even though sometimes reality don't reflect actual truth, but that will be the reality. If he's convicted as an auror, then that will be the reality from here on out. But for now, it's just an allegation. You know, Chris has enough money to fight these type of things, so we'll just have to see how this story develops, and you know, what comes of it.
Yeah, and I think that it's very, I think when it comes to like Chris Brown, I get it. Like, these celebrities are doing like a lot of things, and they are essentially like, you know, they're playboys. Like, they go off and they have sex and do all these things with all these people. you gotta be careful you have around your circle. If that is a woman that, if that woman is lying, and we're not implying, I'm not implying that. I'm just saying you gotta be careful of your surroundings.
Recording. I'm live.
Yeah. But yeah. Right. But yeah.
So
yeah, it's
we'll see what happens with it. Mm-hmm. The facts will come out.
Right. Okay, so